Hello everyone, my name is Takuto Fukuda. I am going to talk about my gamified composition entitled Super Colliders in this presentation. Super Colliders is a game piece for three pitched musical instruments or vocals with a screen score. Problems and challenges the piece addresses. Jason Freeman points out the problem of the extreme sight reading in music performance with a real-time generated screen score. Performers seldom have the opportunity to study the screen score prior to the performance, as the system often generates a unique version of a score in real-time during every performance. And most screen scores show musical symbols or graphics for only a few seconds on a video display during the performance. These limitations situate the performers against the risk of misinterpretation, which conflicts with the concept of perfection prominent in an age where the proliferation of music records has heightened audience engagement with the reproduction of recorded performances in concerts. This cultural condition highlights the game aspect inherent in music performance, namely, the player's challenge to achieve perfection. That is, a game of either success or failure. Super Colliders explore an alternative approach to turn the risk of failure into an engaging performance, embracing the game aspect of the performance by combining gamification with a screen score in interactive system design. Gamification can create a performance ecosystem in which mistakes play a meaningful role in engendering playful human-computer interaction, while a screen score can mediate performer-computer communication through musical symbols or graphics in a way that is perceptible to the audience. Game design. I aimed to design the piece in such a way that the player's desire to win the game results in an enriching musical performance. Therefore, while some music video games such as Guitar Hero and Dance Dance Revolution are played by the haptic manipulation of a game controller, in this composition, the game is played by sound. A key approach was gamifying the scrolling score and the fixed playhead model in the taxonomy of animated scores. This approach enabled me to design a performance ecosystem in which the interactive computer system poses challenges as musical symbols which the players must interact with to perform. Indeterminacy is introduced to several levels as instrumentation, duration, and detailed figure of contours that musicians play. There is no prescribed score or fixed musical sequence. Although performance instruction is provided, it does not specify when and what the performers must play during the performance. It informs them of the general objective of the game and the attitude needed to meet challenges imposed by the interactive computer system. Performers are free to choose several musical parameters such as the desired playing technique, control type, and dynamics for their performance. Goals and rules. The players compete with each other in four rounds of the game. One grand winner is identified at the end of the game. To be the grand winner, a player must win the most rounds. Players must earn 1,080 life points faster than the other players to win each of the four rounds. They crash their avatars with blobs moving continually from left to right on the screen score to earn life points. The players begin the game with 540 life points. Players earn 1 life point per clash. However, all 3 players lose a point if all of them miss a clash. Therefore, there are 2 possible consequences of the game. One scenario is that one musician earns the most points, so he or she wins the round. Another option is an all-dead scenario, meaning all the musicians lose and the computer wins. Notably, the third round is designed such that a human performer always wins. Gamified screen score. The term screen score refers to the graphical or symbolic representation of music projected visually on a screen. This model often shows musical notes or symbols that represent musical information moving from right to left and a fixed playhead. The notes are played when they overlap on the playhead. In this piece, the scrolling score and fixed playhead model is gamified as mentioned previously. The musical notes on the screen score are replaced by moving blobs, namely orange rectangles and gray dots, that are representations of midi notes and targets which players must clash with their avatars, replacing the fixed playhead. The gamified screen score shows three types of elements: three musicians' avatars, three life point indicators, and moving blobs. The three avatars are represented by three dots in different colors. Each avatar is labeled with a musician's name and positioned on the right side on the screen. The three life point indicators represent the player's life points, and each indicator elongates to the top of the screen as the performer adds life points and drops towards the bottom of the screen as the player loses life points. The moving blobs represent musical notes in the MIDI file, as well as targets with which the avatars must collide to earn life points in the game. The vertical position of each blob is mapped to each parameter. The blobs appear in the order of musical notes in the MIDI sequence in every round, and the blobs move continuously from left to right except during the third round. During the third round, the blobs bounce up, down, left, and right. Although blobs are still mapped to musical notes to determine the initial vertical position by the computer, the bouncing behavior makes it difficult to associate the blobs with particular pitches. Gameplay. The piece allows two alternative setups, either musicians face the main gamified screen score with their backs to the audience, or the players face the audience and look at monitor displays. The performers control their avatars by performing ascending or descending glissandi quietly or loudly. The pitch change is mapped to the vertical position of the performer's avatars. Avatars move to the upper edge of the screen when the musicians play ascending pitch changes, and to the bottom of the screen when they play descending pitch changes. The performers need to play the optimal length of the glissandi in a desired direction, namely up or down, at appropriate timings to adjust the avatar's position to the location of their target blobs. Loudness is mapped to the horizontal position and size of the avatars. Avatars are aligned on the right side of the screen when the performer plays silent or very quietly. The speed at which avatars move from right to left depends on how loudly the musicians play. The performers need to play loudly to crash against the blobs with the avatar before other players hit it. The size of the avatars enlarges as the performers play louder, and the enlarged surface allows the avatar to crash with more blobs. This feature is intended to motivate players to perform louder so they can earn more life points. Interactive computer system design. The interactive computer system is effective when optimizing the challenge's difficulty to the commensurate level with the performer's skills. To achieve this, the computer system consists of two components, a MIDI sequencer and a second-order Markov chain algorithm. The MIDI sequencer solves the initial seed challenges, and the algorithm monitors the performer's ability and adjusts the difficulty level of subsequent challenges in real time. The MIDI sequencer outputs MIDI notes from a pre-programmed MIDI sequence of the Baha invention number 1 as elements of the challenges. The system visualizes the MIDI notes as blobs on the screen score. The second-order Markov chain algorithm plays a key role in optimizing blob behaviors. These behaviors have a significant impact on the level of challenges posed to the performers. The algorithm continues tailoring the difficulty level according to the performer's history of successes since the beginning of the performance. Another important role of the Markov chain algorithm is a contribution to achieving my artistic aim, namely performers' interventions that gradually override the Baha invention. As the algorithm continues tailoring the difficulty level of the challenge, so does the algorithm overrides the MIDI sequence of the Baha invention with most dissimilar sequence from the original. The Markov chain algorithm's behavior changes in every round. During round 1, the algorithm learns the moving blobs representing the musical notes in Baha's invention number 1. During the performance of the first round, the algorithm creates a state transition matrix that stores a weight of the probability of every pitch progression between three subsequently crushed MIDI notes represented by blobs on the screen score. In the following rounds, the algorithm performs two tasks simultaneously, generating a blob sequence according to weighted random choice of the pitch progressions entered in the state transition matrix and renewing the weight of the probability based on the newly detected pitch progressions represented by blob collisions. Notably, the state transition matrix is not flushed after every round, but maintained for further renewal in subsequent rounds. Progressions are detected in three different ways. During rounds 1 and 3, they are detected when the moving blobs on the screen score collide with avatars. During round 2, they are detected when moving blobs are missed by all avatars. During round 4, they are detected when blobs are intercepted and missed by avatars. Conclusion. Super Colliders applied the concept of gamification to a screen score to invoke playfulness in performer-computer interactions. I believe that the gamified screen score has the potential to engender a playful human-computer interaction through optimizing the challenge's difficulty to the commensurate level with the performer's skills, as the gamified screen score is not just an intermediary of musical symbols between the Markov chain algorithm and human performers. Instead, it is a performance ecosystem in which multiple active agents continuously interact with each other through various modalities, regardless of whether they are humans or computers. Thank you very much for listening.